So I'm the guy who wrote What Happens When a High-Priced Call Girl Throws Vag at You. And that's a great article. It's countermeasures to what happens when we get rich. So that's the exit, okay? That's the exit. And this is the room. And then what happens when a high-priced call girl throws vagina at you is they literally throw vagina at you. And it's tough to avoid, but this is how you do it. You get a room with multiple exits, such as this, okay? That's another room. That's the adjoining room. And then when you're exiting the room, you want to look like you are waitstaff. You want to look like you want to put on your tuxedo, which I've got in the closet. And you want to take that, you want to just say, when you're exiting your own room from the side room, you want to say, if you're even stopped, which most cases you're not because you look like your catering staff running on food, is you want to say, that Mr. Cheng, he is not a nice man. And then exit. Separate, extend, and escape. If you're writing this down, grab a pen. Separate, extend, and escape. When putty gets thrown at you, you really want to sidestep it. There's countermeasures to it. Exiting the room. Also, you want to book a backup room. You don't want to be in that same room. Here's a reason. At first, it was because, people want to have a leverage over you when they throw putty at you because that putty was paid for or managed to wedge in as a test, as leverage over you. Now, what it also is since it's sort of not a test because a lot of arrangements are open, it's also a test for productivity. I mean, if somebody throws vag at you and you can't dodge it and the next day you're not productive, that goes massively against you. And or just do what I do is just come up with a genius methodology and countermeasures for when a call girl throws putty at you.